The latest Liam Neeson action thriller has actually come out in theaters. So let's talk about it. When a successful bank robber wants to turn himself in and return the money, he instead finds himself on the run when he's double-crossed by crooked FBI agents. Seems a bit like Liam Neeson has created his own little subgenre of action thrillers. I thought he'd said in some interviews that he was done making these kinds of movies, but here we have another one of them. Let me know what you thought about it down below in the comment section, or if you haven't seen it yet, let me know your favorite of the Liam Neeson action thrillers, and let's get started talking about the good. And probably the best thing about this movie is that it knows exactly what it is, who it's for, and it delivers the experience the target audience wants from a film like this. The runtime's just over 90 minutes long, and you get all the sequences you're supposed to get in a thriller like this. There's a chase, there's a fight sequence, an explosion, some stunt work, and just enough kind of flesh on the characters' bones to make them interesting. On that specific point, Liam Neeson's character in this film is a little bit more likable than he is in a lot of the other Liam Neeson thrillers, kind of in his subgenre. His characters are frequently like alcoholics, former alcoholics, deadbeat dads, kind of jerks, or they're just kind of a figure kind of going through the adventure, but you don't learn too much about what kind of drives their characters. That's not the case in this movie. He has a clear motivation for his action to be redeemed in that he's found a girl that he's in love with. And so you see a lot of the two of them interacting back and forth. And through his relationship with his girlfriend, it dives into why he started robbing banks. It just makes him a more sympathetic, likable character. Along those same lines, Kate Walsh plays his girlfriend, and she's designed to be very fun and likable. You also have Jeffrey Donovan in the mix as a good FBI agent trying to track down Liam Neeson's character. There's not a whole lot on the page for him to necessarily shine in the role, but there are some nice details with the character about the divorce that he's going through and this dog that he has throughout the film. They just add some little touches to make the character kind of interesting. Just in general, if you're in the mood for one of these movies on a Saturday afternoon, this will deliver what you're looking for. From there, let's move on to the mixed aspects of the film. And the big thing here isn't necessarily the movie itself, but the trailer gives away 80% of the movie. This is one of the worst examples of a trailer that just walks you through the events of the movie in order, except for the last 10 or 15 minutes. And that's pretty frustrating with a movie like this that in general is already a pretty familiar concept. With that said, let's move on to the bad. And the big issue here is that it's all very familiar. You've seen movies like this before. You've seen movies like this before that star Liam Neeson, and it doesn't really add anything new to the genre. It's just another one of these films. And even as you kind of go through the film, there's so many points in time where you're thinking to yourself, why don't they just do this? Why don't they just do that? Because the movie doesn't necessarily put enough obstacles in the way of them just putting the truth out there. The main villains in it aren't doing a great job of hiding what they're up to or keeping it secretive, in which case it feels very in the open. Thus, the villains are much more exposed than necessarily our protagonist that's on the run. And so just in general, you don't feel necessarily as on the edge of your seat as you should in the middle of a thriller like this. Likewise, the production value seems cheaper than it should have been, specifically an explosion that takes place that clearly is mostly CGI, and then the aftermath is clearly mostly CGI fire. And it pulls you out of the movie when you're seeing such kind of a corny effect where you're thinking they couldn't blow up a house? They couldn't set a house on fire? Real quick, before I give you my final take on this one, be sure to tell me what you thought down below in the comment section, or let me know your favorite Liam Neeson action thriller. Also, I've done some other content on Liam Neeson. You can check that out right up here. If you've enjoyed this review, you'll definitely like that video right up there. Honest Thief is a middle-of-the-road Liam Neeson action thriller. It's nowhere near the best, and it's also nowhere near the worst. You know exactly exactly what you're in for. If you like this kind of thing, you're going to get more of the stuff that you enjoy. But if you're a skeptic that's not into these things at all, it's not going to win you over. I am a fan of this kind of thing, so I got enough of what I wanted, though just barely. Overall, I'll go with a B minus on the entertainment scale. It's a 6.5. And if you like this kind of thing, go ahead and rent it. No need to rush out to the theaters, but it's worth checking out when it's on home video. If you want more content like this, check out that video right over there. Thank you so much for watching, and keep talking movies too much.